Abandon Sacred Beast, Episode 3. Last time we the wrong umbrella.
You two are soaking wet. Get in the wagon.
Thank you for helping us.
Well, aren't you the blind girl, thank you? So, where were the two of you headed anyway? The town broke. Did you say roadkill? You've got to be kidding. Why would you go there?
Roadkill?
I'm afraid. And because of his antics, it's like the place is still stuck in a war. Look, there it is up ahead. Our town where the war never ends.
Never ending war. The Minotaur's Fortress. Yeah.
You know that fortress you saw? It was built by an incarnate. He's a Minotaur. He's good with his hands and has superhuman strength, specializing in fortress building. I heard he built a fortress in just 3 days during the war. But I'm sure you know more about this than I do. After the war, he came back home to live here in Roguehill. And then one day, he just started building that fortress. The fortress gets bigger by the day. He keeps destroying nearby buildings so he can get more materials for it. The longer it goes on, the more damage this town will take. We have to stop him. Fast.
Are you going to kill him, too? Since he's an incarnate?
What is the deal with this girl?
Her father was an incarnate as well.
Yeah, she's involved in this.
You are going to kill him. Isn't that why you're here? Why do you have to do that? If the fortress is a problem, then we should convince him to stop building it. And to top it off, you're treating him as if he were a nuisance. I don't get it. It's just plain wrong. I will not accept your plan. You hear me? There has to be a better way than this.
Convince him, huh? That's certainly a fine idea. If only that were possible.
There's no reason to die.
Citizens, prepare yourselves for war. Never forget the flames that burned our homeland, the remains of our fallen friends, the murderous eyes of our enemies, their menacing and deadly bayonets.
Close the gates,
build more walls, store up provisions, and polish.
Where is this supposed enemy anyway?
But the war's been over for some time.
How long will this continue?
But some still not hunger for battle.
He's perpetually battling the enemy and dragging everyone in this town with him.
How pathetic. Getting cold feet?
Did you get what I asked for?
Yeah, I'll bring it to your room later.
I'll make my move at nightfall.
Are there less casualties?
Seems this is really bothering you.
Why is he the one?
Huh?
He fought too. He protected these people and this entire town. He risked his life and helped bring an end to the war. It's so sad. I don't get it.
Come with me, please.
What's this?
These people lost their homes because of him.
Shelters.
Since he built the fortress, they have nowhere else to go. Still, the fact is, we do have peace now thanks to the efforts of the Incarnate. However, protecting the livelihoods of these people is our responsibility.
Yeah. Just trying to make them live the best way they know how.
It's strange. Why is he up there all by himself? What exactly is it that he's fighting?
I don't know. The only ones who can understand the incarnates are the ones who share the same fate.
What's that?
Hank asked me to get this for him.
Incarnate bullets.
These are no ordinary bullets. They can take the lives of incarnates. They're God-killer bullets. They aren't as powerful as the originals, but they'll be effective enough. I wonder how he feels when he has to use these bullets.
And justifies the means, I take it. Tragic, isn't it? At least I'm knocking this out of me. Guy's pretty ripped.
Are you alright?
No.
Nightmares of his past. Still haunts him.
It looked like you were having a nightmare.
Yeah, it was. So did I say anything?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
I see.
Time to begin the hunt.
Are you sure? You're really gonna go?
Yes.
Someone asked
you. It looks like a fight is truly what he wants. You think you're coming with me?
I won't cause any trouble.
But you won't be able to pull the trigger. Pathetic.
Stay close to me then.
Can't fight, then hide. A lot
he had all the materials he needed with too much time on his hands, and there was no one around to interfere. Pay attention if you're gonna wander in here.
Full of booby traps.
Security guards who tried to get in.
So the booby trap. Lots of them. There's a graveyard in there. Multiple casualties. Idiots. What do we say about staying close?
Walk exactly where I walk from now on.
Show me the death of me.
So, what exactly was he like? The man who built this fortress, I mean.
He was an extremely cowardly man. Everything made him panic. His name was Theodore Sherman.
How do you even get involved in the war in the first place?
You scared?
It's been drafted.
What about you, Captain? Aren't you scared too?
it. I don't want to end up like them. I don't want to have to die like that.
Yes, I am scared. So I do this. I want to know I've done everything I can. I prepare thoroughly before every battle because it helps ease my fears. So tell me, is there something you can do to help ease yours?
Ease your fears. Should I count to 10?
Anyway,
deep breaths.
That's what I taught him.
It's close.
Is there something wrong?
Stay
here. Right there, please. Stay put for the time being. We'll continue ahead on my own.
On your own? No, wait, hang on a minute.
Sorry, nothing else to worry about.
He never had any intention of bringing you along, sorry to say.
Liza?
Figured as much.
Had enough yet? If you're planning on going further, then you really will die.
You were following us this whole time?
Yes, I followed you both in here, so I could escort you back out. Because Hank asked me to.
Huh?
Now that that's settled, let's go. Don't worry, kiddo. I'll get you back even safer than Hank's.
That's not the problem.
I just want to know. I want to know what Hank is trying to accomplish. I can't forgive him. That's why it's important I understand what he's doing. I need to see it with my own eyes.
That'll scar you for life.
I have to go. I need to stay by Hank's side. There has to be a way.
Got him out. Assistance.
Wait! What are you doing that for? Liza, stop!
Just standing there shaking that thing isn't gonna open it, you know. Usually there's something nearby.
Here, come. A switch or something. Oh.
Don't worry. Well, go on now. Aren't you gonna find Hank?
Liza, but you... Yes.
I'm glad about this, so.
Captain! Welcome, sir! I didn't expect that you'd actually come. Look at this! I built it! Our
Kamikaze, I think.
But I've created this giant fortress to protect us. We no longer have to be afraid of any enemy ever again!
You
idiot. Where is this so-called enemy?
Look around, they're all over the place. They're targeting us from the shadows, even now. They sneak up on you, in the guise of children with all-knowing eyes. No matter how thick I make these walls, or how many traps I set, they're coming to kill me. Bigger.
Sounds like he's a lectures.
The more powerful fortress. Otherwise, they're going to kill me. They'll kill me.
I truly lost it.
Let's end this, Theo.
One on one.
You can't betray me. Not now. We used to fight side by side.
That makes this a little more harder for him.
I'm the enemy that's come to kill you. Let's go. Enemy? It's happening. Finally, an enemy has appeared.
And the Minotaur bears its horns.
For any kind of enemy. It was you who taught me that. To overcome fear, you have to always be prepared.
And cue the fight.
It might be impressive that you can dodge that. However...
Pitfall.
I told you, I've prepared for anything!
Trap my cannons. Bring a primal.
It's already begun. Let's hurry. You wanted to observe Hank, well now's your chance.
Right! But Liza, isn't it true that Hank's also an incarnate?
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
But he looks just like any other normal person does. Exactly what type of incarnate? a kind of
wolf.
You stop right there! Weren't you former comrades who fought together? Please stop!
It's no use.
Chad reason with
him. He lost his mind a long time ago. Besides, Hank is gonna be just fine.
He survived worse. Not bad. Cut it with his bare hand. There we go.
Hank is one of the few incarnates who transforms and then reveals his true power only at nighttime.
Nocturnal beast, though. Here we go. PTSD kicking in.
Little one died.
Hope you stand up alone.
I don't want to end up dying like that, dammit! That's why I prepared myself, so I can overcome my fear! And yet it never ends! No matter how big I built this fortress, no matter how many traps I set, this fear of dying never goes away! Tell me, please! How much more do I have to prepare? Theo, let me end this for you.
Broke his axe and slashed him. It's over, Theo.
Captain, am I going to die? I see. It's true then. In that case, I guess I don't really need to be scared anymore. This feels nice. I'm no longer afraid of anything.
The journey is sooner than you think. And the rest is history.
The Beast Hunter. He kills incarnates. Beasts who were once regarded as heroes. I wonder how my father was with him, and what he said back then. Were his words filled with hatred or regret? Or perhaps...
Next preview.
Extermination squads, coup de grace. Thank goodness they've hunted down that beast. It's quite impressive. What do you think about our new hero's fine performance, Mr. President? Captain Claude, the expression on your face is rather stern. You're going to frighten folks. Why don't you try smiling a bit?
I'll only smile after every last beast is hunted down.
Cool. outside. That was so scary. Occupation tube. What was in that tube?
It looks like fate continues to be on your side, Hank. Fight on.
How long?
It's the largest bridge on this continent. It's 200.
Start episode 4.
The incarnates moving faster than we
thought. Fire! Why haven't you killed it yet?
How is he any different from one of
next episode, March of the Behemoth.